Hello students, welcome back to our next session of standard 10th subject social science, and today we are going to cover part 2 of chapter number 10, India agriculture. So students, let's cover our next topic. In this topic, we will cover the major agricultural crops of India. And due to the diversities in geographical condition, climate, variety of land, the amount of rainfall, etc., different crops are grown in different part of our country, India. Let's take the first part, food grains. Grains are cultivated in about 75% of total area sown, and about 50% of total production comes from grain. So we can make out from here that the large and the majority part of the area is used for the cultivation of grain. Major food grains are as follows. Very first, we will take paddy, which means rice. Paddy is our most important crop, and its production is an important part of national economy also. A large majority of the world and about half of the population of India uses rice. India stands second in world after China in paddy production. Paddy is sown over 1/4 of total sown area. Paddy is a crop of torrid zone. Hot and humid climate, minimum temperature of 20 degrees Celsius, fertile alluvial soil, and more than 100 semi of rainfall are necessary for more production. In the region of less rainfall in Punjab, Haryana and Uttar Pradesh, this crop is taken through irrigation. More human labor is necessary for paddy cultivation. West Bengal, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Bihar, Orissa are major paddy producing states. The crop is taken 2 or 3 times in West Bengal, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Orissa, Tamil Nadu. And in Gujarat, paddy is grown in Surat, Tapi, Panchmahal, Ahmedabad, Kheda, Anand, Valsad districts. Paddy requires more water, and however, instead of keeping the paddy fields fully underwater, paddy is grown by irrigating through sprinkler using less water. So we can understand that rice is one of the chief grain of India, and moreover the country has the largest area under the rice cultivation, as it is one of the principal food crops of our people. It is also in the fact that the dominant crop of the country is rice. India is one of the leading producer of this crop also, and rice is the basic food crop, and being a tropical plant, it flourishes comfortably in hot and humid climate. Now rice is mainly grown in rained area that received the heavy annual rainfall. That's why it is fundamentally a kharif crop in India. Again, it demands the temperature around 25 degrees Celsius or 20 degrees Celsius and rainfall more than 100 semi. So rice is also grown through irrigation in those areas that receive comparatively less rainfall, and rice is the staple food of eastern and southern part of India. Again, knowing the more about it, rice can be cultivated by different method also in different region based on the type of region, but in India still it is being grown in the traditional method and are still in use for harvesting rice. So students, let's take the second topic, that is the wheat. As we all know, wheat is the main cereal crop in India, and wheat is the second important crop of our country after paddy. wheat is grown over 1/3 of arable land of our country. It is the substantial food of the people of Northwest India. Wheat is a rabi crop of temperate zone. It requires black or fertile loamy soil and more than 75 inch of annual rainfall. Wheat can be grown in the region of lesser rainfall with irrigation. Wheat cannot be grown in the area receiving more than 100 inch rainfall. Less labor force is required as mechanization is introduced in wheat cultivation. After the Green Revolution, the wheat production is almost double. Wheat cultivation is carried out mostly in Punjab, Haryana and Western Uttar Pradesh. These states contribute about 2/3 of the total national production. As there is an irrigation facility in this state, there is more per hectare production. Due to the canal water in Punjab, there is abundant wheat production. That is why Punjab is called a wheat bowl of India. Wheat is also produced in states of Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Gujarat, Maharashtra, West Bengal, etc. Balia wheat is produced in Bhal region of Gujarat. Besides Mehsana, Rajkot, Junagadh, Kheda also produce wheat. Among all food grains used in daily meals, wheat is the best. Many items like rotli, bhakri, sev, shiro, lapshi, ladu, sukhri, bread, puri, cake, biscuit. These all are prepared from wheat. And among all grains, wheat is the most nutritious. That is why wheat is also called the king of grains. So wheat is a, we can say it's a worldwide staple food also. The next crop is jowar. Jowar is the most produced grain in India after paddy and wheat. This crop is grown very widely in the dry and less rainy region of southern peninsula. Jowar is both kharif and rabi crop. Temperature between 25 degree to 30 degree Celsius and 125 centimeter of rainfall, black and loamy soil are favorable conditions. It is produced in Maharashtra, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Gujarat states. Maximum farming of jowar in Gujarat is done in Surat and Tapi. The advantage of this crop is that it can be cultivated in both kharif and rabi season. And jowar is the fifth most important cereal crop in the world after rice, wheat, maize and barley. Now come to the next topic, that is the millet. Millet is considered to be the grain of laborers. It is grown in the region having temperate between 25 to 30 degrees Celsius, the rainfall between 40 to 50 centimeter and light sandy soil. Major states producing millets are Rajasthan, Gujarat, Uttar Pradesh and Maharashtra. The Banaskantha district in Gujarat leads in millet production in Gujarat. Let's come to the next, maize. This is a kharif crop. Maize is the most grown crop in the world after paddy and wheat. Maize is grown more in hilly area and it is staple food of people. Maize contains starch, oil protein, biofuel, etc. So it is used more in industrial production. Sloppy, black, hard, rocky and water having gentle flow are more suitable for its cultivation. Rainfall between 50 to 100 cm and 21 degree to 27 degree Celsius temperature are favorable factors. Its usage is increasing in animal fodders, dhani and the oil. It is increasingly used as animal fodder, making popcorns and for edible oil. Major states producing maize are Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, Punjab, Jammu and Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh. In Gujarat, maize is more grown in Panchmahal, Dahod, Sabarkantha and Aravalli district. The next we will take is the pulses. Again, pulse is the main source of protein for vegetarian people. Tuvir, moong, gram, peas, beans, mutt, udad. These are considered as pulses. Tuvir, udad, moong, mutt are kharif crops. Gram, peas and lentil, that is masoor, are rabi crops. Pulses are grown in all states except wherein rainfall is more. Major pulses producing states are Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Odisha, Bihar, Andhra Pradesh, etc. In Gujarat, tuvir is sown more in Vadodara district, moong and mutt in Kutch district and udad in Patan district. Nitrogen is reinstated in soil by growing pulses, so it is sown as the intercrop along within or after the main food crops. Now let's know some things about the nagli, which we also say ragi. Nagli holds a unique place in grass fruit crop sown in Gujarat. Nagli is a staple food of Adivasi people in hilly region. Among all grass food crops sown in Gujarat and in India, the per hectare production of nagli is maximum. Nagli is known as finger millet or African millet in English and is known as bauta in Gujarati. Nagli is extremely nutritious grass food crop. There is more of protein, mineral and vitamin in its grain. As there is more fiber in nagli, it is very advantageous for the patients of diabetes and cardiac patients. The proportion of calcium and iron is also more in nagli compared to the other crops, so it is used for removing malnutrition and in making for baby food. The Adivasi farmers eat rotala made from nagli flour. Besides, biscuits, chocolates, toast, naan khatai, wafer, papri, etc. are also prepared from its flour. So overall, we can make out that it is a healthy and nutritious and also calorie conscious people can go for it. The next which we are going to cover is the oil seeds. Groundnut, till, soya bean, castor, mustard, sunflower, etc. are considered to be the oil seeds. They hold an important position in Indian meal. After edible oil is extracted from the oil seeds, the remaining oil cake is used as animal fodder and also as a biomimetic manure. The first oil seed which we are going to take is the groundnut. Groundnut holds an important position in oil seeds. Black and mixture of loamy and sandy soil, land which would not retain water, 20 degree to 25 degree Celsius temperature and 50 to 70 centimeter rainfalls are favorable conditions. Groundnut is sown as kharif crop and wherever there is irrigation facility, it can be sown during summer also. Gujarat, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu and Maharashtra are major producer of groundnut. India ranks second after China in world in groundnut production. Gujarat leads the country in groundnut production. District of Junagadh, Gir, Somnath, Amreli, Rajkot, Bhavnagar etc. produce groundnut. Groundnut oil is used more in Gujarat as edible oil. Next is the sesam or till. Till oil is used in India since ages. In North India it is rain based kharif crop. In South India, it is sown as rabi crop and occasionally as a zayat crop also. Almost all the states grow till. Among all oil seeds, till has more content of oil. In almost all part of the world, it is used as an edible oil. Major producer of till are Gujarat, Tamil Nadu, West Bengal, Karnataka and Madhya Pradesh states. Gujarat ranks first in India in terms of till production and the area sown. Banaskantha grows maximum till. Maximum export of till in world is done by India. The next is mustard. Again, this is a rabi crop and is an important crop of North India. Mustard seeds and its oil are used for medicine and also as edible oil. Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, West Bengal, Gujarat and Madhya Pradesh are major producers of mustard. Next is the coconut. Coconut is a plantation crop of hot and humid coastal climate and saline land. In India, the coconut plantations are found in Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Andaman, Nicobar, etc. In Gujarat, coconut is grown in coastal region and a special type of coconut tree which is shorter and giving more yield is developed. In South India, coconut oil extracted from coconut kernel is used as edible oil also. Besides, its water is useful as a healthy drink. The next one is castor oil. Castor oil is also known as divela locally. It is both kharif as well as rabi crop. With 64%, India is largest producer in castor in world. China and Brazil come next respectively. About 80% of its productions come from Gujarat. Andhra Pradesh and Rajasthan are other producers. In Gujarat, the district of Banaskantha, Patan, Sabarkantha, Rajkot, Junagadh, Amreli, etc. produce in little quantity. The oil from cotton seed, sunflower, paddy and maize also are used increasingly as edible oils. Students, now next which we are going to cover is the beverages. Very first is the tea. Tea is a plant of tropical as well as temperate zone. The tea leaf and its tender sprouts are processed and its powder and small leaves are used in drinks. India produces maximum tea after China. Sri Lanka, China and India are leading tea exporters. Sloppy lands where the water easily flows down, good iron content, 20 to 30 degrees Celsius temperature and about 200 cm of rainfall coming in the form of showers throughout the year are favorable conditions for tea plantation. Tea is grown more in Assam, West Bengal, Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh, Tamil Nadu and Karnataka. Assam and West Bengal produce 75% tea of the nation. The tea leaves are very skillfully plucked from the plant. Next is the coffee. Coffee is red over the slopes of mountain in the shades of larger trees in such a way that no direct sunlight falls on the coffee leaves. The coffee crops need 150 to 200 cm rainfall and 15 to 28 degree Celsius temperature and slopy mountain land. Coffee is grown in abundance in Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu. Coorg area of Karnataka is well known region for coffee production. Coffee seeds are extracted out of the nuts, grinded and then it is used as a drink. So as we all know that in our country, India, mostly the tea, people's favorite drinks are tea and coffee in hot beverages. Next is cocoa. Cocoa is prepared out of the seeds of cocoa fruits. Cocoa is a beverage. Chocolate is prepared from cocoa. It requires hot and humid climate and excessive rainfall. African countries are its major producer. Cocoa production is on increase in Kerala, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu states. Now let's come to the cash crop. Very first is the cotton. Cotton is a kharif crop. Cotton holds an important place in cash crops in Gujarat and in India. At world level, India is at the second place in production, usage and export of cotton. Cotton means without seeds is obtained from the cotton plant. And this cotton is also known as the white gold. Besides the cotton seeds, oil is used to prepare edible oil and its seeds, the oil cakes are used as animal food. Black lava soil which can retain humidity for longer time. Soil with plenty of mineral contains hot and humid climate, 20 to 35 degrees Celsius temperature and 30 to 70 centimeter rainfall. These are the favorable conditions for cotton. The growing season for cotton is about 6 to 8 months. Frost damages the cotton crops. In India, major cotton producing states are Gujarat, Maharashtra, Telangana, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Haryana, Rajasthan, Punjab, Tamil Nadu, Odisha, etc. As a farmer of Gujarat have accepted Mitti cotton sales, Gujarat stands first in India in area, sown, productivity, total production and quality of cotton. Cotton is grown more in Surendranagar, Rajkot, Vadodara, Ahmedabad, Sabarkantha, Mehsana, Botad, Bharuch, Kheda, Surat, Panchmahal, Amreli, Bhavnagar, Patan, Junagadh and Jamnagar district. So cotton is a very valuable cash crop as it is, there is a demand in the market for it and it will give the good return also to the farmers, so it is also known as the white gold. Another is sugarcane. Sugarcane is a major crop in India. Maximum sugarcane is grown in India in the world. In production, India ranks second after Brazil. Sugar, gur, khansari, ethanol are produced out of sugarcane. Black fertile alluvial lava soil, hot and humid climate, 21 to 27 degrees Celsius temperature, 75 to 100 centimeter rainfall are necessary for sugarcane. Uttar Pradesh is at the top in area sown, but Maharashtra leads in the production. South Gujarat and Saurashtra produce more sugarcane in Gujarat. The next is the jute. India produces maximum of jute in the world. The jute fiber is also called golden fiber. Jute clothes, gunny bags, mattresses, ropes, bags, footwear, handicraft items are made from jute. India has a strong competition from Bangladesh with regard to cheap labor in just industry. Jute requires fertile soil of delta region where new sediment is deposited every year, hot and humid climate, 30 to 40 degrees Celsius temperature and more than 100 centimeter rainfall. Jute is grown more in Ganga Delta in West Bengal, Assam, Bihar, Orissa and Uttar Pradesh. The next topic which we are going to cover is tobacco. Tobacco is a kharif crop, sandy loamy soil, 20 degree Celsius temperature and 100 centimeter rainfalls are suitable for tobacco cultivation. Soil is determining factor then climate for tobacco cultivation. Major four countries in the world which lead export tobacco are China, Brazil, India and USA. Gujarat, Andhra Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh and Karnataka are major states producing tobacco in India. The Charotar region of Kheda and Anand district, Mehsana, Vadodara, Panchmahal grow more tobacco. About 80% of BD tobacco of India is produced in Gujarat. Tobacco is used to make gutkha, BD, cigarettes, snuffs, etc. Again, tobacco consumption is harmful to health. Sikkim is the first state to ban tobacco or gutkha. The next is the rubber. Rubber is prepared out of milk oozing out of latex tree. Acetic acid is mixed with the milk collected from the rubber plantation. Then it is heated on low temperature to obtain rubber. It is used in many industrial products like tire, tubes, etc. Rubber plantation is carried out in the region of hot and humid climate and heavy rainfall. Malaysia ranks first in the world in rubber production. In India, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Assam, Tripura are rubber producing states. Now let's take the medicinal condiments and spices. Gujarat ranks first in the production of cumin seeds, fennel seeds and isabgul in the world. Besides this, India leads in productions and exports of dry corianders, fenugreek, mustard, suma, ajwain. India contributes about 35% in total world production of condiments. India, black pepper, cinnamon, cloves are in high demand in the country and world. Ashwagandha, tulsi, kariyatu, mindi, awal, white musli, madhushani, ashok, garmal, inibipar, galo, aloe vera are included as medicinal plants and mint, menthol, palm rosa, lemongrass are included as flavored crops. Let's take the next, that is fruits, vegetables and flowers. In fruits production, India ranks second after China. Fruits like banana, mango, apple, grape, naspati, orange, etc. are grown in India. Bananas are grown in Tamil Nadu, Gujarat and Maharashtra, apple in Jammu Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, and grapes in Uttarakhand, Maharashtra, Himachal Pradesh, Jammu Kashmir, Punjab, Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh. As the grape production is less than its demand, it is imported from Afghanistan, Pakistan and Australia. Besides, various vegetables are grown. Flowers like rose, juhi, mogro, galgota, etc. are also cultivated. Thus, various crops are grown in India. So now let's come to the next topic. In agriculture sector, what the changes are there? Technical and institutional reforms in agriculture. Earlier, farming was carried out by simple and ordinary farm implements like sickle, spade, hoe, drill, plow, bullock cart, etc. Now modern implements have entered into it, of which tractors, trailers, rotavators, etc. are common. Besides, modern equipments like threshers and harvesters are used in wheat harvesting. There is an increase in usage of chemical fertilizers, hybrid seeds, BT seeds and insecticides, drip irrigations and green houses. Now what are the technical reforms? Reforms means changes which has took from the traditional method to the modern methods. The changes which have taken place in seeds, fertilizer and farm implements in India are known as technical reforms. Very first, the farmer who earlier used leather buckets and water wheels now use submersible pumps or monoblock pumps, solar pumps, drip irrigation and sprinkles. Next is chemical fertilizers like D-ammonia phosphate, nitrogen, phosphorus, potash, urea and other biofertilizers, liquid biofertilizers, biotech seeds are used. Next, farmers are constantly guided through radio, television, newspaper, DD Kisan channel, SMS or mobile by the Kisan toll-free number 1800-180-1551, which is known as Kisan Call Center. Government farms web portals, e-Khedut and mobile app like Agri Market. So we can understand that now the agriculture sector is moving toward the digital platform also, where the farmers are getting the facilities. New agriculture research and new techniques are conveyed to the farmers in villages by Gram Sevak. A farmer training center is established in every district headquarters wherein the farmers are given training. Next, recent informations and guidance are provided to farmers through agriculture fair in Gujarat. Next is agricultural university and agricultural colleges are established in every state. Agricultural universities are established in Dantewada, Junagadh, Anand and Navsari in Gujarat. These universities carry out research and prepare new experts in agriculture. Next is, besides this, Indian Councils of Agriculture Research, that is ICAR, and Department of Agriculture Research and Education, that is DARE, they are active at national level. The next topic, institutional reforms. So the reforms or changes connected with land ownership, crop subsidy and sale of farm produce are considered to be the institutional reforms in India. Government has discarded the landlordism and stopped the exploitation of farmers. Under the law, land to the tiller means the Land Tenancy Act, the land tillers have been given their rights to become the owner of the land. Next, the disparity among the landowners has been removed by Land Ceiling Act. Next, the farmers are given financial help for crop subsidy by Kisan Credit Card and by Nationalized and Cooperative Bank. Next, farmers are also given full insurance protections of their crop through Prime Minister Crop Insurance Scheme. Next, when the crop fails due to the drought or through excessive rain, farmers are given financial help by government. Next, by providing legal support, an open auction process is made widespread for a sale of farm products in marketing yards. Next, facilities like cooperative societies, market associations, cooperative warehouse, Cold storages, transportation and communications, etc. have been provided so that farmers would get the minimum support price of the farm products. Next, following organizations are operating for the purchase of the farm products from the farmers are supported price. First is National Agriculture Cooperative Marketing Federation of India. Second, Gujarat Cooperative Oil Seeds Growers Federation. Third is National Dairy Development Board. Now let's go with the next topic, Green Revolution. Green Revolution took place in our country in the decade of 1960, but before that there was a time where there was an acute shortage of food grain in our country. An agrarian country had to import food grains, so the country was struggling against such dependent condition. Now let's see the points. Very first, the extraordinary increase in agriculture production because of improved seeds, increased use of chemical fertilizers, intense efforts of farmers, widespread arrangement for electricity distribution, improved facility in irrigation, etc. is known as Green Revolution. What are the main objective of Green Revolution? So it is to increase the agriculture production. Farmers were encouraged to use chemical fertilizers and insecticides more. This led to attain the target to increase the agriculture production. There has been a record production of wheat and paddy due to Green Revolution. Where there was a scarcity of food grains in the country, today there is sufficient storage of food grains. Once drought was hazards of regular interval in India, its adverse effects are not seen after the Green Revolution. Due to the buffer stock of food grains, the condition of drought of scarcity are faced conveniently. The self-sufficiency in food grain is a landmark of historical achievements of Green Revolution, and today the production of cash crop has increased and the production of pulses and other cereals has decreased with the repetitions of the same crop. To reach the stage where other countries of the world have progressed using better technology in agrarian field, we will have to be ready for the next Green Revolution. So it's an alarming situation where the Green Revolution has to take the second time if same condition will be there. If more importance is given to the cash crops, then we have to be ready for the next Green Revolution. Now let's see what's the role of agriculture in India economy. Agriculture is the main occupation in India. The pressure which India had at the time of independence is now reduced somewhat. However, it still has an important contribution in the Indian economy. Very first, it provides employment to about one half of the population of country. Second, agriculture holds about 70% of total gross domestic production, that is GDP. Paddy, wheat, oilseeds, cotton, jute, sugarcane, tobacco, potatoes, etc. are major agriculture products of India. Much foreign exchange is earned from their exports. Next, India ranks second in the world in agrarian production. Next, industries like cotton, textile, sugar, paper, oil, etc. as well as industries regarding the food processing get their raw material from agriculture products only. So agriculture provides food to the people of India. The Indian contribution is not consistent in the world agriculture market because of irregular and uncertain rain and inadequate facility or irrigation. Food security is necessary for any country today. If the demand for the food grain is increasing and if the food grain have to be imported, then the political independence of that country may be at risk. So we have become self-reliant in field of grain production due to Green Revolution. Along with the increase in farm production, there is an increase in population of country also. In 1951, India's population was 36 crore 10 lakhs, which today is more than 125 crores. This has increased the demand for food grain. However, there has been an increase in production of food grains in our country during last 5 years. In 1950-51, India had produced 51 crore tons of food grains, which has increased to a record level of 265.04 crore tons in 2013-14. With the food grains which we have today, the minimum requirement of country can be fulfilled. It is necessary to maintain buffer stocks and to increase it. By the buffer stock of grains, the scarcity of grains can be prevented during droughts, or in the case of inadequate production of food grains, the wastage of food grain can be prevented by implement of the techniques to preserve the grains in warehouses. The hunger of thousands of families can be satisfied with these buffer stocks if distribution among them free of charge. It is strong necessity of the time to stop the wastage of food. It is necessary to strengthen food stocking and arrangement to conserve it. It is a good beginning that the government has made provision to supply the food grains up to the poor people through Food Security Act. Yes, students, now let's take the next and the last topic, that is the impact of globalization on Indian agriculture. So according to our new economic policy, the policy of globalization has been implemented with the purpose that Indian farmers can sell his products in the world market and earn profit. Many changes also took place in the agriculture field due to globalization. The process of export or import crops production is made very simple here. Cotton, chilies and tea are now available in Chinese market, and various fruits from world are now available in Indian market. The costly genetically modified BT seeds sold by multinational companies are now available in India. Due to this, farming has become costly. The productions of cotton and maize has increased. With the import becoming smoother, the domestic farm products have to face tough competition. Some products have gained global market, hence the necessity of registration of their patent. It is necessary to register qualitative farm production as national patent in the world market. Now, to face the competition in agriculture products in global market, India will have to adopt a new technology and concentrate on quality. A series of planned steps will have to be taken to increase the economic prosperity and solidarity of people. Now, within the increase of population also, the probable future increase in the demand for agriculture products, and to maintain the march in economic progress, it is necessary to arrange the strategy for second green revolution. Okay, students, thank you and stay safe and stay healthy.